This is my startup sequence. I've got a checklist, as you can see here. That way I can track what I need to do, because I keep forgetting. First on the list is the seat adjustment. It's not necessary at the moment. Battery 1 and 2. Actually here. We've got a limited time for the battery drains, else you could use the external power, but we don't need it now. Forward pump, aft pump, inner pump, outer pump, because we have external fuel tanks, fuel quantity. And then we test the fuel gauge. Yep, working. We have 200 liters in the tanks and 1000 on the side. So in total 1200. The beacon. Then we have the blade tip lights and the panel lights. The next one is fire extinguisher. Maybe I should do a test here. I'm not sure. I'm not how to, unsure how to do it. So this is what I usually do. Then it's the intercom to talk to the ground. VHF 1, VHF 2, data links. Oop. And standby attitude indicator. The INU and its heater. Then we have ACON. Next on the list is the the APU selector. It's already in on the APU, so we can start it. Checking the gauge. This is 900 Celsius. This is zero. It's building up pressure. On. The next one in the list is calling flight lead. Blade 2-1, this is blade 2-2. Ready for engine startup. And you would say if it's okay or not. And next on the list is the rotor brake. Cutoff valves, shutoff valves. Those are here. Governors. Engine selector, it should go on the left. You can start the engine. Temperature's going up. Waiting for combustion. This is all bleed air, the first 200 RPMs. Now we have combustion, so the engine is running. When it reaches about 800, then we can start the second engine. There we go. Right engine start. Again, bleed air is pushing him up. Waiting for compression and combustion. There we go. It's combusting.
Watch a ground.
Increase the automatic engine power. Starting the left. AC gen. Right AC gen. It would be the point to kill the external power, but we don't have any. Abris. APU is no longer needed because we have engine power, so we can shut it off. Ejection system. The ejection seat. Weapons control. IFF. NAV. Laser warning. Chaff flag. No chaff. Shutting these things fall to 1.7 or 1. The dampers. All but the heading. Because we need the protection. Master, operate, because we have nothing to plan. The standby altitude. This one. Altitude warning radar, 30 meters is what I usually set it for. The squall needs to turn on. The laser is off, checking that. Program the flare dispenser. 0.25. Setting up the apers. Option. Track heading needs to go to magnetic. Altitude to barrel. Formation lights are over here. They're only being used when there's low visibility, but there is none today, so it's good. The nav lights on. On means 100%. Landing light. It's on. And we have the icing. You can set the trim. A rough setting. This is defense in and out. Yep, that's it. Well, this is my startup. The only thing I have to do now is wait for permission for the taxi and then release the handbrake, total lock, and we're good to go, I think. If you have any suggestions or stuff that I'm forgetting and not doing, yeah, please let me know.